so I can see it again. that gets on the line, obviously you got to convince Priest. We'll find out later who you're cheering for. We always like to start by doing something together, and that something is the wave. We're going to start the wave on that side of the gym, send it all the way down here. If you're able, stand up, hands in the air, loud as possible. All right, starting there. On the count of three, are you ready? 1, 2, 3, wave! Okay, not bad for the first try. One more time, only much, much louder this time. Ready? 1, 2, 3, go! Nice and done. Special shout out to the people of the baseline. Well done.
Coming from on YouTube. I'm not fucking even loud as Michael.
Stay tuned for second quarter action.
Thank you.
Connor Grandfall making the first. Number 8, Josh Vector, picking up the second foul on the play. Here we go, the Michael McDonald's first ball. Thank you.
He belonged to Michael Pickett's second ball that play. I'll put his mile Michael Devine shoot it to it. He's wasted a ton of it. Well, here we are, championship game, 1-4 game. It could come down to fans for him. Let's find out who you're cheering for. How many people here are cheering for Jason Scruggs? How many people here are cheering for Dakota? That's a foul number four, gentlemen. That's his second foul. Thank you. Alex Day Bowie, his first foul. Foul on 11, Ito Salido, that's his third foul. But Blake Kenner at the line for Dakota. Second foul of all, number 10, Alex Oladipo. The book is mailed to Michael at the line for the kill. Pastor Dakota, have requested a time out. Well, folks, if you love basketball, you're obviously in the right place. Not only are you watching the SCAC Varsity Boys there participate, coming up next, scheduled to start at 7:30, is the SCAC Varsity Girls Championship game. That game is going to feature, and feel free to cheer if you're here for that game, it's going to feature the Glendale Lions. I guess they're not here yet. Taking off the Dakota Lancers. So again, both SCAC championships being decided tonight. And later on this week, Thursday and Saturday, the Elite Eight for the provincial championships are going to be happening right here at Dakota in this very gym. So you do not want to leave this place if you're a basketball fan. Well, there number nine, and he will welcome Michael. He now has three fouls. Excuse me, out of Michael. Shooting two for Dakota. Learn the speed and take it. They heard you have this third call. Lucas Conway made him a first two.
Sharks.
Yes, this Varsity Boys Championship game is score, Dakota 43, James Potts 29. Second, back to him.
runs. Alex Oladipo has 7 points, and April Weldemichael has 15 points. And for Dakota, Carter Grandpa has 13 points. And leading all scorers in the game is Kismaya Michael with 22 points. Quante is his first follower. They turned it, maybe the Huffy keep two. Number 10, Alex Oladipo, picking up his third foul. Well, they're not able to welcome Michael. He now has 4 fouls. But the point
where the line
That's the end of the early first call, okay? But see, are they being taken at the line? Or James Brooks?
Thank you.
St. Louis Bruins have requested a time out. All right, Sacramento gave us the set late in the third quarter. We have to find out if the crowd support has changed. How many people here are cheering for James Bugs? How many people here are cheering for the Time War? Don't play it even. One more time. Who's cheering for the Broncos? Who's cheering for the Lancers? Later on, the fourth quarter will make it a little more challenging. So be ready. First down to the sixth, they are eligible. Blake Henner, we get a second foul there. I will be the paintball, shooting two for change bugs. Thank you. And Jaden's friends have requested a time out. Well, yes, it is Night of Champions here at SCAC Varsity Basketball. As we said, following this one, scheduled to start at 7:30, it's the Varsity Girls Championship game, then on taking on Dakota. But when this one ends, don't go anywhere, because yes, we will be giving up the finalist and championship banners. We go back to schools, the championship team is getting t-shirts, and yes, they're on the Player of the Game t-shirt. Oh, I know you're thinking there's probably one straight stand. You'd be wrong. The T-shirt machine was clearly on extra fast, but we got more than one player in the game for each team better. There's a foul at the mission of the girl, it's a second foul. Number 8, Joshua, start picking up his third foul on the play. He now has 4 fouls. Thank you. In the long way, though, he is number 5 fouls and is fouled out of the game. Passing man, and a nice finish by Alex Olas Abel. Thank you.
Alex.
I don't even know. At the line to shoot too. There you go, Leo, get the first one to go. Second call, number 5, Adams and Sergeant Field. Open number 13, Hale Leo, in line sheet 2. From the 26th JH Brooks parking lot, who knows a little for free? Thank you. Zach, bring up being his first ball. Deep in the green, you make the first. Bobby with 11, he knows 0, but just pick 12. He has 5 of the game. Don't put 15 on him. Lineup on the cards for the presentation of all the swag. First of all, fans, can we get a big round of applause for both teams for an exciting presentation today? A lot of back and forth, two good shots, exactly what you want to get to that game. Here to help present the awards. From the host Dakota Collegiate, Mr. Ryan Hudson and Mr. Cyril Hidalgo. Also, Mr. Hidalgo with some Bruins background too, so it's only fair. First of all, we're going to announce the players of the game. And like we said, most places you get one player in the game for team, but now the T-shirt machine is spitting out. We have two players to get from each team. First of all, from James Brooks, one of the players of the game. Abel Rundle-Michael. And our second player in the game is Josh Hector. The players of the game for Dakota, Connor Grandbaugh. She's my own uncle! Congratulations, players of the game. Next up, we're going to present the finalist banner. Let's pull up the captains of the James Brooks Broncos. Yeah. We have Austin Gay from James Dunphy. They keep the photo all day long. And now it is the championship banner. Let's call the champions. Somebody call the matches. We also have championship t-shirts for every member of the winning team. This is the bonus, is we don't need to hand them out till this table. I think he's going to sell them on eBay, so check that out later. We're also announcing the All-Stars. I'm not sure if all of these folks are here, but if they are, please come down and pick up your All-Star t-shirt. This is sort of full season of SCAC play. First of all, from Nelson McIntyre, Jordan Hernandez. All right, Jordan, all the way from Nelson Mack. Nicely done. Also an All-Star from Blue Riel. Russell with Doma Lara. Congratulations, Russell. Our third All-Star from Castle Bay, Paul Moreno. Always not good. The other two All-Stars, the other two All-Stars both play in the championship game tonight. First of all, for James Brooks, he has won it all. And the final All-Star from Dakota, Connor Brandon. And finally, we've got the LRSD award for the fourth season. Well, if we've got multiple players in the game to go, we gotta have pro teams. From Dakota, it's Blake Penner, just got out of the box, and go LRSD TV. Congratulations to all those fun teams. Like we said, you don't go anywhere. Up next, Varsity Girls Championship game, Glenmont taking on Dakota. on, man. You're like a mentor. And now your starters for the hometown Dakota Archers. Number two, Taylor Sapp. Number eight, Harry Singing. Number nine, Hope Lamar. Number 11, Isabel Boost. And number 21, Dario Long. Your officials for this game are generous and in the carpet and on the scores table. Sports, progress, aerobatic, Grayson. And again, the weather outside is nice, but not nice enough to open the retractable roof. We are keeping it closed with the next game. So let us get, let's cheer for Johnny Long and just a chance to make it a 3-point play. He's passing in, it's finished off by Dario Long. Thank you. Stealing two, or is he post? Was Taylor Schaaf. Every resident age, line out. Well, fans, we tried to get some terrible varsity boys game. It was okay. But I think when we do it here, it's going to be better. There are fans here with signs. If you're showing up with signs, I know you're a good fan. We're going to do something together to start. We're going to do the wave. We're going to start the wave at this end, send it all the way across the gym. If you're able to stand, scream, loud as possible. On the count of three, starting over here. Ready? 1, 2, 3, play! Yeah, I was hoping to name the weekend's way better. Much harder this time. On the count of three, 1, 2, 3, play! That was much better on this side. Those of you who want to pull up that stick, not as impressive, not at all. And Dakota have requested a timeout. All right, we said this in the first game, 2 years ago, championship on the line. It could come down to the end support. Let's find out who we're cheering for. How many people here are cheering for Dreadlock? Nicely done. How many people here are cheering for Dakota?
just put me in the bus line with your time. Please put me in the bus line. Please check out your program.
Awesome work,
guys. Keep that fucking all right. Well done.
What about me? Mama.
And so there's a lot of shooting to it. What is that? What is that? That is sweet. The rock is please. We're having a little spark to drama. Take a hug and say, oh, please. First of all, if I'm not doing it, it's not please. Thank you. Thank you.
But the medical jury are robbed. That's a god for the card of Julie. That's a juice queen for green. The version of the is that. He's been so fascinating in his final game, finished off by Trevor's nap. There you have it. We have the first quarter of this championship game. Your score, Poland 37, Lebanon 8. Stay tuned for second quarter action. From the corner, is he post-reading? He is 23 counties waiting. Great pass, finished off by Blakey Spectrum.
Thank you.
Those two for go for a sorry, you're wrong, you can stay there. Requested a time out. All right, second quarter action. Let's find out. There's still three in the song is for earlier. Who here is cheering for Dakota? And who's cheering for Dunham? Let's try it one more time. Who's cheering for Dakota? And who's cheering for Dakota? What? Keep that going all night. Awesome.
Thank you.
long 2 minutes of the game expected. Was it first to get their second foul, but Sweden for three. Because championship game, your score, Dakota 64, Ludlow 15. Stay tuned for second half action. numbers at halftime. For Glenline, Zoe Everett has 4 points, and Tay Hockenting has 9. And for Dakota, Darnie Mullen has 12, and leading all scorers with 14 points is Abby Sweeney.
Gave them some stuff, just
Nice baseline run there from Zoe Everett. Taylor Schimp, we have their first foul on that one. Taylor's gonna pick up her second ball, hopefully. They are shooting two for one. Taylor should have picked up his third foul on play. And Ledlaw have requested a timeout. Well, if you missed it earlier on the league champions, first game tonight, Varsity Boys Championship. Dakota taking on JV's Bronze. Dakota won the championship there. And as we said earlier, if you're a basketball fan, you're going to want to be in this gym next week as well. SCAC is hosting the provincial playdowns. So that means the Elite Eight matches are happening here next Thursday and Saturday, three times for Varsity Boys and Varsity Girls. The winners of those 8 weeks here in Dakota will advance the provincial final four championships. Those are all happening at the new event facility. Basketball fans definitely will want to be here next week as well.
Well, One of the scouts heard this answer. Sucks. There is no.
Nice drive to the hoop there. It's like bucket two for the lender. Okay. Taking two shots from the free throw line on that play, number 21, John Garofalo picked up his third foul.
Thank you.
Number 21, Garland, number fourth foul. Open glove loss, number 21, and I'm going to at the line, shoot two. Wait, what's the name of the problem?
Che film, mamma? Che film?
There you have it, fans, at the end of the three quarters of this championship game. The score, Dakota 82, Glenlaw 19. Stay tuned for fourth quarter action. again, Rue, if you got our second foul, then. Long whereabouts, Christy Boots.
Thank you.
And what have requested a timeout. All right, you know, sometimes in the second half, the players get tired. Let's see if it's happening to the fans as well, if the story entered me. Who here is cheering for Glenlon? Pretty good fourth quarter energy. Who here is cheering for Dakota? Very nice. Let's try it one more time. Who's cheering for the Lions? Who's cheering for the Lions? Lions! Lions! Any team, who's fast box start from the hell? What's your question? Who else wants to cheer? Come on. Inside, finished off by D.D. Holloway. Blacklock have requested a time out. Well, again, you're not going to want to leave after the match because, yes, that's where all the swag comes out.
championship grand finalist members. We've also got not one, but two MVP awards for each player of the game for each team. And we've got the All-Star Canucks and Bohemian MVPs. So stay in your seats after them. You do not want to miss those presentations. Then you Jake, come on, shoot two for the comeback. It's long here, but it's great. Come on, baby. Thank you.
Where you Rabbits fans in this championship game. Final score, Dakota 87, Ludlow 27. Dakota for the SCAC Varsity Girls Basketball Champions. Fans, can we get a huge round of applause for both teams for that excellent run of the game? And well, Ryan, can we also get a round of applause for the Spanish team on all the volunteers in the tournament? So, we've got, as we said, many, many things to give out. Double the number of players in the game. Maybe give it up to the fucking Collegiate with the Ryan Hudson and the next year old Nico. Oh, yeah, you get a gun. And if you're a Dakota, this is your gun from the West Circle. You should be doing a national region at this point. Your mark could be on the line. First of all, players of the game, players plural, two for each team from the Red Hot Lions, one of the players in the game, number 13, Tim Hudson. And the second player of the game, but not mine, number 18, Zoe Miller. And now the players of the game, the champ, Dakota Lancers, number 10, Anna Simmers. He's going to blow up some of these socials to destroy them. Next up is the banner presentation. First of all, we're going to call up the finalists, the captains of the Glenmont Lions, to give the finalist banner. Again, in the family game with your championship heart, you well to run on. And by the way, while I'm giving a shout out to Glenmont, I want to personally give a shout out to the Glenmont fans. The game didn't go the way you might have wanted to, but you guys brought the nice all game. Well done, Glenmont fans. You're welcome here anytime. Now to not during lunches, apparently. Sorry, Mr. Thomas, I believe you're not allowed here during lunches. Otherwise, okay, I get it. The championship, and let's call it the championship. Well done. We're also going to announce the SMU's All-Stars for the entire season. Not sure if this person's here, but one of the All-Stars from Steinbach, Peyton Keeler. I guess not. That would have been a long one. Yeah, I guess not. We'll get it to me. One of the All-Stars can play this game tonight from Glenmont, Taya Hatton. The other three All-Stars, all from Dakota. First of all, Hope the Rock. Secondly, Abby Sweeney. And the final All-Star from Dakota, Taylor Shanks. There you have it. The SCAC All-Stars for the 2024 season. All right. Oh, you want the picture? We're going to be still all this society. We do have, again, like two players in the game. Co-MVPs. Again, close to the co-actors. Starting from all the pieces close. On a personal note, I would like to call out one of the signs that if it's not first, you're last. As the best dad joke sign of the evening. Well done. There it is. Again, thanks to both teams. Thank you, fans. This is what High Space Fans is all about. Like we said, we'll see you next week. But it did so. Elite 8 with Varsity Boys and Varsity Girls. Have a safe year home, everybody.